Good afternoon and welcome along to the Tuesday afternoon show, and great to have your company as always. Thanks for everybody in the chat room, and you with my good self, the bear in the chair with Airshow World. And what we have today is it's classic Airshow day, and that's what we're going to be doing for you. So without further ado, we'll start the show off with a little bit of luck. We should be heading over to Humberside. It's old footage, I'll just tell you that, so don't expect it to be crystal clear because it's old VHS footage. But hey, that doesn't detract from it at all. It's 1992. That's where we're going back to right now. So with a little bit of luck. And of course, many thanks to everybody that's joined us in the chat room today. I'm hoping we'll be able to run today's show. The internet speed, like I put in the message earlier in the chat room, is abysmal. I don't know what Virgin Media are doing, but the upload speed is absolutely dreadful. So it's possible we may have to abandon today's show and start it a little later in the day. But we'll let it roll. We'll let it run for the moment. But if it starts really playing up, we'll have to move along and do the show later today. So where is it? It's Humberside. That's what we're starting with today. Humberside Airshow back in 1992, so enjoy some of the footage that's coming up. A quick mention to all the folks in the chat room, and then I'm going to go really quiet and let you enjoy the video. So we've got Andrew Austin, thank you for joining us, Aviation Kid, we've got Finber Aviation, Aviation Kid, he won't be around much, but hey, Aviation Kid, who knows? Tune in tonight, around about 5:15. You may get a surprise, okay? Who else have we got? We got Steve, SHGP, Virtual Aviation. Let's keep Pirate of the Missouri. Good afternoon to you. And keep on going through the list. We've got Irwin. Keep on going. Go down the list. We've got Gordon, GB Model Zone, photo for you. PJ, he's there, Awash 2004, the main man, Elvis, hope you're feeling a little bit better. If not, hope you get better soon. Say hi to Tracy, Snoopy, good day to you. James, good afternoon to you as well. And everybody, Neil Hubbard. So everybody, thanks for joining us. There's a racing car going down there. Okay, I'm going to go quiet, enjoy the show, and I will join you in just a couple of minutes. Fingers crossed. The internet gets better. It has, actually. The internet speed has just gone up at 1 o'clock. So, hey, they must have known. I'm not going to I'm not going to say anything. Let's just hope it behaves itself. Okay, let's take it away.
Blowing the smoke out.
Yes, they know their number for the moment.
Now this reaches 300 miles an hour in this short space. Watch this.
Looking for 350 plus miles an hour down the runway. 350,
he says.
60 miles per second per second.
Flight information service to Barnsley, 1007, reporting this comes to a bearing.
Go on, Catalina. Beat the car. Come on, keep going. That's better. And on the screen, you can see one of our favourites. It's the Catalina. Love that aircraft.
Approach now 12467 right then.
Good afternoon. We've got a select amount of 20 degrees.
Peggy Rio.
He's in
just a very short appearance there of the Buccaneer. But don't worry, hey, we've got lots of other videos of the Buccaneer. And you'll also get a glimpse a little bit later of the Vulcan as well. But the Vulcan did a very short appearance as well on this particular show. But I don't know whether it was a fuel priority or what, but it's always good to see the Vulcan. But we've been, hey, you guys have been spoilt the last few days. Certainly been featuring the Vulcan quite a bit.
Booster, at your discretion, you clear to commence your display. And contact the tower 118.55. 3 miles.
Well, Fimba Aviation, that is dedication for you, isn't it, hey? Thank you very much for all your support. Much appreciated. Thank you. Bandit 99 and also Sleepy Spider. Good evening to you, should I say. Sleepy Spider is over there in Western Australia, where it's probably round about 11 p.m. I'm just guessing on that, but he'll let us know. Well, as you can see, certainly bringing out some of the very, very old aircraft you just saw a moment ago, the Fokker F-27 Friendship.
Watch what the people are doing and correct mistakes. So, do you want us to go to on the starboard side of the Nimrod? If you actually land on your left-hand side of the Nimrod and
got to say a big thank you to James. He sent this across a couple of weeks ago. I've been very, very busy editing it and doing my best, making it pretty and all the rest. Of course, it is grainy footage because it's from an old VHS tape. But still fantastic to be able to restore, get these videos back and put them back out there. So I certainly hope you're enjoying it. Thank you very much to Simon. He's actually sharing this over on Facebook. So thank you there, Simon. Much appreciated. And if you are watching on Facebook, a very good afternoon to you. Don't forget, keep on sharing. Let's get as many folks as possible. And if you want to join in with the chat and everything else, you can do that right now on the Airshow World YouTube channel as well. So just a brief appearance today of the Vulcan, but so let's go quiet so you can hear this. Bandit 99, you are a superstar. Thank you very much for that very kind donation. He says, another great video, Stu. Thank you very much. We've been very busy on that one, I can tell you. James sent the video clips over bit by bit. And bit by bit, I edited it all for you. So certainly hope you're enjoying it. And thank you for the kind comment. Much appreciated. Good afternoon to Phil Tovey as well. He's over there in Warwick. Historic Warwick, beautiful place. For anybody outside of England, one place you really should go, Warwick Castle. Love it. Beautiful place. Heather Ramsey, good afternoon to you. And Chris as well. He was one of the first in today, together with our very good friend Fimba. So thank you. And of course, good afternoon to our good friend, that's Andrew Austin. Also, we've got Andy Hare. As you can hear with the kids in the background, my goodness, they always get excited with the red arrows. Hey, so do I, I tell you. Rock on, yeah.
Finish one we call the mirror bend.
And if you like the old footage as much as I do, I'm really looking forward as well to next Monday. I'll tell you about that in just a minute. Next Monday, what's it all about? Well, as you can see, I've made a DVD out of this. And you're also going to see some Duxford, where I've also made a DVD. But next Monday, my very good friend Andy, that's Andy Hare, you see, he's in the chat room right now. Probably on his, just before he goes into work, he's in his car, probably down there in Southampton, that's sort of part of the world. Anyway, I found one of his old VHS tapes that he gave me many, many years ago. And there's some fabulous, absolutely brilliant footage on there. And we're going to be showing you that DVD. We've given you some previews, like we did yesterday. And it's from Middle Wallop and Yeovilton back in 1998. I had to think for a minute. But also, Andy is he's been going through some old VHS tapes and he's come across some absolute crackers. And you're going to love them. He's going to send them over. I'm going to put them through this jazzy machine that I've got. And we'll restore them and we shall put them out. So that's something to look forward to as well. That's next Monday afternoon. But today, we're looking at Humberside Airshow, the James sent across just a couple of weeks ago, and I've done the editing. It's not been through the upscaling machine, this particular one, because unfortunately we can't meet up at the moment, as you rightly know, so I wasn't able to get the original VHS tapes, but doesn't matter. James, it looks fantastic. It looks good this time. I hope it's coming out okay on your side and it's not stalling or anything. Looks like the internet is behaving itself at the moment. Hey, if you're watching on Facebook, I'm going to have a quick look over there. So if you want to put a message in Facebook, do it right now. I'll say hi to you.
Gunship or naval attack helicopter, which could look after itself like any other aircraft, was a lot of
contact. Left 11 o'clock to your range of 1-2 miles at the moment. Crossing is slowly from left to right, if not side to turn left, heading 2-9-0.
Like other helicopters, you can equip link space for.
So it's time to give a quick mention to the guys over there watching on Facebook. So we've got Simon Johnson, we've got Phil Tovey. Hey, he's watching on both. Good man, keep it up. Russell Sadler, he says, hey, big hello to you all. He's watching from the Philippines with a big smiley face, so thank you very much. He said originally he lived in Ramsgate in Kent, and his question is, would you happen to have anything from the air shows at RAF Manston? Well, that's one certainly for Andy, so I'll check with Andy Hare. Andy may have something that he can send across. Also, we've got Bjorn watching over in Holland. So wherever you're watching this, good afternoon to you. Keep sharing if you're on Facebook, and keep sharing as well, of course. If you're watching on YouTube, enjoy.
Thanks, give way to the Harrier, just taxiing out.
Links can be used to pass target data. If you're there, I'll
Cheers, Andy. No problem. Good afternoon also to Joel. Hiya, Joel. Nice to see you in the chat room. Snoopy as well. Cheers, Lee, please. You're enjoying the show this afternoon. Andy, have a good afternoon, okay, mate, and keep up the great work, and hey, we'll catch you later, okay? Probably catch you on your lunch break. We may be doing a show round about 5:15 this afternoon as well.
What is he missing really from it now is the dial cover, which I think would be a very expensive item to put back.
By the way, if you like a little bit of Formula One, you know, the Grand Prix sort of stuff, well, I was down at Brands Hatch for their British Grand Prix back in 1986. You remember? You may not remember. Depend on your age, but I was down there with a video camera, and again, it's very grainy footage, but they had a bit of an air show. So we'll feature a little bit of that, and you'll see a bit of Formula One action as well. So that's coming up right after this. You want to see a beluga? Hey, I can bring you a beluga. We were fortunate enough, round about 6 weeks ago, just before Christmas time, and we had that beluga that came into East Midlands Airport, the XL. So if I have time, I'll probably give that a whirl towards the end of the show. Really? Now that's interesting then, Chris. Well, that will probably mean quite a bit to you then, my man. I will show you that and the start of the race as well, okay? It's not the best footage or anything like that because it's grainy and what have you. And certainly worth seeing though, so stick around. So come on then, you aviation buffs, let me know the name of this display team, because watch this, they are absolutely awesome. I believe Brian Lacomba is one of the pilots. What's the name of the team?
The wingmen are coming to adjust to the leader all the time. They're watching the leader for making on him
So Fimba is saying, hey, no snow whereabouts he is, but hey, they certainly have had snow today up in North Yorkshire, South Yorkshire as well, I believe, but in the famous horse racing part of the world, oh, goodness gracious, had a photo, well, a video came over at 6 o'clock this morning, and the snow yet again is knee deep. So I wouldn't fancy riding those horses today in this, or in what they have anyway. It's pretty bad up there. Zoril Doa, is that how you say your... Oh, God, this is a difficult one. Zoril Doa da Silva. I don't know how you say your name, so apologies. But let us know whereabouts you're watching from, okay? When I see a new name come up, I think, whereabouts are they? Jazzy John, good to see you in the chat room today. Hope you join the show. Hey, can you remember the name of this particular aerobatic team? I wish I could. As I said, I'm pretty sure one of the pilots is our brilliant Brian Lacomba, very sadly no longer with us. But what was the name of them? Gosh.
Up to the
When I was editing that, I absolutely loved it. And I tell you, watching it back now, even better. So I hope you enjoyed that brilliant, brilliant display. Well, thank you very much to your mom there, Finbar. Much appreciated. So, Finbar, whereabouts in the world are you, hey? So he says he didn't get the snow today, so, well, we haven't either at East Midlands Airport. But, yes. I just always like to know where in the world are you? It's the Team Toyota, must be, hey? Steve, you're an absolute diamond. Thank you very much for putting that information in the chat room over here on YouTube. See, I'm going to be really mean. You see, if you want to find out about all of that, because Steve from is, let's give him his proper title, SHGP Virtual Aviation. He's put in the full list of the aircraft that were at this Humberside air show. So thank you very much for that. That's in the chat room over here on YouTube. So if you want to see that and you're watching on Facebook, come and join us right now. Put a message in the chat room and I'll say hi to you. Airshow World YouTube. We'll see you on there now. Good afternoon to our good friend, that's Morris. Andrew, it's fantastic to see you. That's my very good friend, Andrew, with his, he's got a really nice Mini, I tell you. open top Mini, beautiful. We looked really nice. Andrew, great to see you. He says, hi Stu, hope you're well. Hope to see you soon back in Suffolk. You bet your bottom dollar. Julie's getting all excited. She saw the beluga outside her house flying over the top. Bring it on. I know, we missed you, Morris. We missed you yesterday as well. We did an extra special bonus show as well last night at around about 5:15. You never know, we might do that today. Okay, Stephen, we will tell you all about it. Where is it? And what year? 1992 was the year, and it's the Humberside Airshow. Coming up right after this, between the next this and the next video, which will be Duxford 1992, another DVD I've put together. In between of that, what we're going to do, we're going to have a little bit of, we're going to go to Brands Hatch for the British Grand Prix back in 1986. Again, it's, you can imagine, in 1986, very, very old footage, grainy and what have you. But they had an air show. And we'll see a bit of Formula One cars as well. So that's coming up in around about 15 minutes from now. Make that 10 minutes. Rock and roll.
Go after.
Approach.
Ready. From Lassiter and Jackson. Step left.
Waldemar, hope you say your name like that. Good to see you.
Bandit
99, Richard Staff, Gary Owen. Good afternoon. He says from Bridlington, East Yorkshire. Well, I hope you missed the snow over there in East Yorkshire. West Yorkshire have got it really, really bad. Andrew, he didn't get the notification for last night's show. Oh boy, did you miss last night? You missed a cracker, I can tell you. You must watch it back. It was, yeah. You'll enjoy it. It was pretty, it was all right. It was good. It was better than good. It was brilliant.
That was terrible.
The Muppets, sorry. I get carried away. Also, hi to Gary Williams. So keep joining the party. Good to see you. That's all the folks here on YouTube in the chat room right now. Come over, join us. Where are you watching this?
Sort of manual operation for the same responses as you would from the turbine, from the jet. And if, of course, you are going on to multi engine which in fact has telecom engines.
Call for Telica, Roger, flight information service, and report passing Beverly.
So as promised, coming up in just 2 minutes from now, or thereabouts, don't hold me to that. We're going back even further in time, 1992, ha, that's nothing. With a TARDIS, we can go anywhere. We're going back to 1986 with an air show, bit of a mini air show they had in the break of the for the British Grand Prix. It was like the warm-up just before they had the Grand Prix. So that, hey, before we do that, here's the front page of the DVD. There we go. You see, Airshow World, Humberside Airshow 1992. And it's a simple one, this. You just click on play all, and away she goes. Simple as that. And we saw this just a little earlier. Right, what have we got coming up for you? Well, as promised, we have that little feature with a little bit of luck coming in about 30 seconds from now, and it was Brands Hatch. Okay, so that's what we've got coming. So just bear with the bear just a moment, because it decided to close that particular window. So it's not a problem, though. I will find it. We had fun and games yesterday, but hopefully, this is what I love about doing live things. You never know what's going to happen. Okay, are you ready? Are you ready, Fred? Have you got that 10 pence still?
No.
Oh, dear. Okay, right. Brands Hatch. With a bit of luck, okay? Remember, this is old footage. Very, very old. And I wish in those days I went to lots more air shows. But, hey, do you remember Coventry Air Show? We'll be showing that at some point from 1985 or 86. Anyway.
And a Brands Hatch. Rise. Terrific. Here she comes, like the great seagull that she is. A beautiful sight in the sky. Nose down, wheels down, just turning now to come over Brands Hatch on this occasion. The show.
Make sure you notice the crowd. How many people? Incredible.
Wave to her, ladies and gentlemen. Concord. Anyway, if only he could get up here, I'd have a chat with him. I wonder if any fortunately and see somebody else perhaps winning. Well, it's very difficult to look at it dispassionately, but I do feel it's probably Battle of Britain Memorial Flight, the Lancaster, the Spitfire, and the Hurricane. Three magnificent aircraft that did so much.
Wait on.
In Europe. It's manufactured in the Eastern Bloc. May I interrupt Victor Norman?
Such a massive, huge crowd. Just incredible. Can you imagine that? I will tell you, I'm not bothered about massive crowds and things, but I tell you what, even I was a bit spooked by so many people. I've never seen so many folks in all my life. Back in those days, they used to let everybody in. Now, as you know, it's limited for the Grand Prix and what have you, but just look at it.
By character. That's it.
And Chris was also there for this special event. So coming up in a minute, we're actually going to see just the start of the race. And I know Chris will remember what happened at the start of the race.
Now, that's a fascinating start. So much slower from behind the barriers, because otherwise the police will have to eject you and evict you from the circuit. And we don't want that to happen. It's such a marvellous day. And here is the climax to our air display at Brands. It is the Vulcan.
So the commentator gentlemen, was referring to comes. People climbing on those hoardings. Scary.
This thing, what a noise. 6 for this particular aircraft was flown by
Mansell's car. He's whisked off the grid and the green flag is waved. They start on their warming up lap. Nelson Piquet.
So when this race actually starts,
Berger.
Pay great attention to this corner now. Okay.
Of Rosberg and Prost, and we have a dramatic situation at the back of the grid. A yellow flag for one of the Acelas. It is now starting. The other one gets away, so let's see. It's Alan Burke who has got away, and it's Pierre Carlo Ginzani who was in difficulties. And I can see his mechanics clearing away their paraphernalia as they go back to the pits in the hope that they have put Pierre Carlo's problems right for the start of the race. Out at Westfield, I'd like to call in Neville Hay just to see that Neville is with us and live from outlap 196.02.
I know I keep saying it, but that crowd.
British Grand Prix.
Have you ever seen anything like it?
They come to take up their position.
I would have loved to have known what the official figures were.
Mansell, Senna.
Don't forget, watch that first corner carefully.
Barbie, and then the first of the Ligiers, Arnoux, then Patrese in the Brabham, Dumfries in the Lotus, Brundle in the Tyrrell, then the Ferrari of Michele Alboreto, the first of the Barclay Arrows, then Alan Jones. We wait for the red lights to come on for the start of the Shell Oils British Grand Prix of 1986. The red lights are on, and as they switch to green, who is it going to be? There they go. and Sinner. Mansell is in trouble. Sinner has gone through into second place, and we've got a car off two, three, four, five cars. With coming off the circuit at Paddock Hill Bend, I can certainly see Pier Carlo Ginzani's Ocella. I can see one of the arrows, and the red lights are on. The race has been stopped. The red lights are on. The race has been stopped. The black flag, Berger, but it's Piquet from Mansell, then Berger, and Ayrton Senna in fourth place. Then we have the two Marlborough McLarens, then Teo Fabi, as they go into the hairpin for the first time. Nannini starts from the pit, and as they come down through Graham Hill Bend, it's Piquet.
Morris, my favourite circuit as well. I love Brands Hatch. And I tell you what, I've got another video that I took at Brands Hatch.
But Nannini is in.
I mean, this goes on for ages. I'm not going to bore you with the race and what have you. If you want to see this race, definitely watch it. Watch this. That was on another occasion. As that was coming towards me, I thought, I hope that doesn't go over the barrier. But it's certainly a race sort of watching the full race somewhere. You'll find it out there. In fact, I've got a copy of it. So the year before that, we've gone back even further in time. Back to 1985. See, I had the video cameras in those days. I wished I'd have done more air shows, I can tell you. Or even gone to Mildenhall to get the SR71 Blackbird. But hey, hey-ho. But what is this all about? Well, it's Donington Park, and it was the week leading up to the Grand Prix of Europe at Brands Hatch, which you may remember, just like the last Grand Prix we're just looking at, Nigel Mansell won this as well. It was his very first Grand Prix victory. It's called the European Grand Prix. It was in October. Beautiful weather as well that particular weekend. So on the sort of build up to it, to get everything all ready, they popped over to Donington Park. As you can see, back in those days, Formula One was accessible. So I just turned up with the video camera. And I was lucky enough to get Alain Prost and the man going round in that Williams at the moment. And that's Keke Rosberg. And if you like Brands Hatch, hey, put a message in there, and on one of the other shows, I will show you some fantastic video footage of why Ayrton Senna was such a special driver. I did this particular clip of Ayrton Senna going round Druids Bend, very, very tight corner, and nobody, and this video proves it, TV never proved the point, but it proves the fact that why he was so brilliant. Nobody else could take the corner as close as Ayrton Senna did. That's something I will probably feature in another show at another time. If I get a few requests for it anyway, that is. And that particular bit of video I was just referring to, it was on what they called the... They had these open days where they used to do tyre test days, which were absolutely brilliant. Very few people there. So you got fantastic clear shots, and that's something I will probably feature if anybody was interested. you remember that line. To right, yeah. He was referring to back it last August, waiting for that U2. Gosh, that was a hot day. It may have been 33 degrees, but I'll tell you what, it was like 40 degrees whereabouts we were. Whoa, it was hot, hot. And I had nothing to drink. So I put the message out. Next thing I knew, a very kind person came over, a friend of mine who didn't live too far away. He popped over and he bought me a load of drinks. So, as you may know, when I do the live streams and or take any videos from this KK Rosberg from East Midlands Airport, you can hear racing cars in the background. And you may have just seen then an aeroplane taking off, because Donington Park is right next to East Midlands Airport. So there's Alan Prost, world champion. Also ex-world champion Keke Rosberg. And for the Formula One experts out there, you may have also spotted the one and only John Watson. So why was John Watson there in his civvies just standing around? What's that all about? Well, I'll tell you, Niki Lauda, he actually hurt his wrist in the previous Grand Prix for this. So on the weekend, or this was the Monday, okay? The following weekend was the Grand Prix of Europe at Brands Hatch. So they needed a stand-in. And you can hear him in the background. So they used John Watson. So if you are interested in this sort of stuff, in another feature, there's John Watson. Looking a very young John Watson. I used to love his commentary on Eurosport. I tell you what, I used to love his style of driving as well, especially at Long Beach, way back in 1983. Both him and Niki Lauda started last on the grid and went to win. Because they were using the, they were the only cars, I think, or one of the very few that were not using the turbo cars back then. And it just suited the circuit. So they went from last to first, and to me it was one of the best drives he ever did. Great driver, and a really nice guy. I was talking to him quite a bit in between the filming of this. Very amenable. So if you like Formula One, that sort of stuff, put a message, and in between some of the aircraft things, I will feature some of this, because I've got lots of Formula One test days at Silverstone and Brands Hatch.
Of course, Melbourne McCarran, your old team, drive for, so that must be quite nice.
Well, they know me and I know them, so it's really been a part of them for years. And we're having the words from second team with me. But I think it's important from my point of view, because they know me and they've known me for a long time. Likewise, I understand how the team works. So it saves the difficulty of going to a strange team and trying to integrate into the team. And that does take some time. I mean, usually it takes a new driver, three or four races to settle. At least when I go to Brands or even here today testing, they know what I'm going to be saying and the kind of things that I need. It's a bit like an earthquake, it's gradually creeping up. sort of actually the best thing is back to get into the car and drive. All the hanging around and waiting is worth the rest of the time.
Hey, stop coughing. Stop coughing in my ear, please. Yeah, I said stop coughing. What do we do? And if you can hear what sounds like a cat, it is a cat. My cat is dying to get out. He's not into Formula One cars as much, obviously. He loves the planes.
Spread it in the block, yeah.
The Alan Prost interview coming up right now. You're not going to be able to hear. He's got a very quiet voice. Here we go. We'll try.
Championship, but that looks as though fingers crossed it can all stay.
How's this car been going this morning?
Very good.
Well, there you go. So hope you enjoyed that extra little bonus. If you like that sort of thing and you'd want to see a little bit more at some point, just put a message. We're not going to have this. We're not going to have that. But with a bit of luck, we should. Right, that's what we got it from. Okay, so that's what we were just looking at. I was just looking for a different video to be able to show you. So just bear with me for 1 minute. I will try, but this might not come up. Oh, yes, it does. So what I'm only going to show you a very small bit of this because you might not like it. But anyway, it was the point I was making, how fantastic Ayrton Senna was at taking these corners. So watch carefully at the other drivers and then see Senna go round Druids. Okay, with a bit of luck, let's hit this. And then we'll get back to the aeroplanes in around about 2 minutes from now. Okay, let's go. Wait for this to catch up. I'm trying my best to get this going. Come on. Let's try that one more time. Let's try that again. Hold on one second. As you can see, totally unedited. This is something that I may feature at another time, okay? Let's get... Here we go. This is the little bit I was talking about. Right on the... as far over as you could go. Watch him again. Here we go. Time. Absolutely beautiful.
Thank you.
there we go. There's lots more of that. It goes on and on. And I've got lots of Formula One. But hey, that's something I thought I'd just pop in for you, because we showed the little bit of aircraft doing their display at the 1986 Grand Prix. So we've got feature number two coming up for you in just a couple of seconds with a little bit of luck with... Excuse me, I can't talk. It's the cup of tea getting stuck. Okay, so we're going to move the show on and have a little look at some of this. So the last part of this particular DVD, you've probably seen before. It was when I was doing the editing stage of it. But I've now put the DVD together. So with this one, yes, you've got the menus. So let's have a look. There we go. You can get to little bits that you want to get to. So it's I think it's, was it 1992? Yes, it is. Okay, so we're gonna play all. I'll have a look at the chat room. Hope you enjoyed that little bit of something a bit different, bit extra, right? Let me know if you like the Formula One type stuff. I'll see what else I can dig out for another show. That last particular clip you saw, that was from Brands Hatch, and there were the tire test days that the I think it was around about the August time they had that for the it was 1985 for the European Grand Prix at Brands Hatch. God, I loved Brands Hatch. What a brilliant place it was. Well, it still is, but they don't have Formula One there anymore. Goodness gracious, with crowds like they used to have. What a place. Best, one of the best circuits, in my opinion. Similar to Spa. Just gradient. I love to see cars like that. You used to get so close. Have you been to Silverstone? You can't get anywhere near them. Anyway, less of the rattle, more the aircraft. Let's take it away. Between that feature, I didn't have time to check on the chat room because I was really busy. But yeah, some great comments. They obviously, you guys like a bit of the Formula One, so I'll try to dig a few more bits and bobs out, okay?
Classic Wings have got the Rapide, 8-seater, biplane airliner.
So we saw parts of this air show a couple of weeks ago, but we got it the wrong way round. So James sent part two over, and he said, I found part one. I said, get it over quick. So he sent it over. I've edited it. I've made a DVD of this as well. Like everything you've seen today, apart from a Formula One, it's all on the DVDs, okay? So don't forget, I do the DVD shows. That's on a Monday. Did I get any signatures of the Formula One drivers? Let me think. I've got one of Ayrton Senna somewhere on the back of a photograph. I was at one of the tyre test days again, which I've actually got on video, and it was at Silverstone. I think it was the year that Nigel Mansell had that fantastic Ferrari. Oh, what a sound that made. That beautiful V12 Ferrari. And I was at the tyre test days for that. And also I was there for when he was in the Williams and all that malarkey. So I probably got just as much motor racing footage as the aircraft. I've got a lot. But anyway, let me know if you're interested, and I may put the odd little bit in every now and again. Sadly, over on Facebook at the moment, we've got Sam Rogers over in Australia. We've got Oliver. Russell Sadler. Simon's over there as well. I'll be giving Simon a call just a little bit later. Simon is going to be the star of the Friday night show. That's going to be the next scheduled show, okay? That's on Friday night. It's going to be on Meet the Fans. If you are watching this over on Facebook and you want to continue watching, don't forget, hey, we're going to be leaving you on Facebook in around about 2 minutes, okay? So it's your 2 minute call. If you want to carry on watching, pop over to Airshow World. That's where the rest of the show and all the fun and the chat in the chat room is going to be. So pop over to Airshow World on YouTube right now. So the Facebook will be closing in 1 minute from now. Thank you for everybody joining us on Facebook today. And I certainly recommend you do pop over, because you're going to love some of the flying that you're going to be seeing coming up. But for the moment, if you're on Facebook, thank you very, very much for joining us. Don't forget the Facebook page. It's called Airshow World Fan Page. It's a group. You can join that. We'll let you in. And you get all the latest information about Airshow World, when we go live and all that good stuff. But thank you for joining us on Facebook. It's exclusively right now only on YouTube. Don't forget, it's absolutely free to watch. Well, I hope I have pulled the right plug out. The question, my favourite racing driver, without a shadow of a doubt, Nigel Mansell. I was a massive, massive Nigel Mansell fan, no doubt about it. I even had a cat called Mansell. When I went to pick the cat up, he sounded just like Nigel Mansell's V12 Ferrari. So he had to be called Mansell. That's a good question. I was just about to ask that. Andrew, who was yours? Of course, I appreciate Lewis Hamilton and what have you, but... hey, to me, it's just not the same, you know? The competition back then with the drivers, goodness gracious, I'm sure you agree. Senna, Prost, Mansell... Well, as we look at a little bit of this, we will try, see if it works anyway, try to see if Maurice is out there. So, hey, Maurice, are you have we got a good connection today or not? Are you actually out there today?
Yes, I'm here. Hopefully it's coming through to you well today. Fingers crossed.
That's not too bad at all, actually. Yeah, we can hear you. I can only hear myself on one side today for some reason, but I don't know why that is, but... So, Maurice, back in 1992, you remember, we featured some of this a couple of weeks ago, but it was part two. We're seeing, like, part one of it today. So, were you there this year, that particular year?
I was. I remember it well. Happy days.
Happy days. What's this aircraft we see at the moment?
The Hawker Sea Fury. I think that was John Bradshaw's.
Right.
Used to be a British Airways pilot. Who owned it. Now local to you, living up at Sywell, of course.
Uh-huh.
John, here comes the
Then, Maurice, did you say this is the Hawker Sea Fury? I'm correct to that, isn't it? Yes. Look at that low flying.
Yeah, beautiful, isn't it?
Absolutely amazing. And what's this aircraft taxiing towards us at the moment?
When I get the sight view, I'll be able to tell which one. I think it's probably the Fighter Collection's original aeroplane, I would think, looking at it.
See, I really like dropping Maurice Wright in it, you see. This is without any warning at all. I just thought, hey, Maurice didn't even know I was going to call him up, so I just thought I'd bring Maurice in just for a moment because I'm not so good on them. These old aircraft, and Maurice is a real expert when it comes to these. It says Old Crow. So that should be the giveaway. So, yes, what do you remember about this aircraft there, Maurice?
Yeah, that's the original Scandian... historic flight aircraft in its original colours when it first came over here.
Now, I'm looking at this, just, you know, being not particularly knowledgeable when it comes to these old aircraft, but the actual size of those is that prop is huge. That particular angle certainly emphasised the point as well. Anything you can tell us about that? I mean... It looks huge. Is that why it was such a powerful aircraft?
Which aircraft are you referring to, Stu?
I'm just looking at that incredible pass just then. The Old Crow, the Mustang that just taxied by. When we had that shot looking behind it, the shot of the prop going round, it looked huge. Well, hopefully we've still got Maurice out there. Yeah, you still getting us okay there, Maurice?
Yeah, you can hear me.
Yeah, I hear you, no problem at all.
We should go for the Corsair with its 40-foot diameter propeller. Dictated that bent wing design. It was such a huge, great propeller, they had to get the ground clearance on it, which required a long undercarriage. But of course, for Navy operations, operating out for carriers, that was a no-can-do. So they cranked the wings deliberately to shorten the undercarriage to allow for the huge propeller.
Ah, so that's on the Corsair. You know, I've always wondered why the wings on the Corsair were like that, so now I know. Okay, Maurice, thank you very much for your input, and hopefully we'll catch you again a little bit later or on another show. So, Maurice, keep enjoying the rest of the show, and we'll get back to the sound of these incredible passes. Oh, just before you do go, Maurice, can you tell us just a little bit about that, the Messerschmitt that we're, that's been chased by that Spitfire? If you could just do that as the last final.
I'm seeing the Spitfire at the moment, so I'm not quite sure which muster.
You're not, can you view, are you seeing this on Skype? Oh, it's a shame. We're struggling to get a hold of Maurice at the moment, but hey, we always have a try. Such a shame. Maurice has got this fantastic knowledge of these aircraft, but unfortunately, his upload speed on the internet is not the best. But thanks, Maurice. We'll catch you later. Keep enjoying the rest of the show. I don't know about you guys, but I absolutely love seeing these old aircraft. Absolutely fabulous. The sound as well. So that's what Tuesday afternoons were all about, bringing you some classic old aircraft. Photo for you. Hopefully you should have us on both sides right now.
Sarah. Photo Charlie, Sarah over. believe it is.
Tango, thank you, Michael.
Happy to go, mate. Classic 3, Roger, as one to depart off the grass, report finals.
Classic 3.
I don't know why that is then. I think it was when I went through on Skype, it seems. But hey, we'll have to put up with that for the rest of the show. I don't know. Hopefully that should have fixed it there. Photo for you. It's coming out on both sides on my system at the moment. Cheers, Steve. Thanks for letting us know that. He should have the bear coming out of both, coming in both ears now. Forget what you're looking at the moment. In fact, both of these shows that you've seen today, they are both available on DVD. I love that one as well. So, if you like this old stuff, you'd like a copy, you know what to do. Just drop me an email, okay? And I'll give you all the info and everything you need to know, okay? But I'll give you that email address in just a moment. I know it's not called the DVD show today, but I have made DVDs of these. And many thanks to James for sending the video across. Sent them a couple of weeks ago. And I've been busy, very busy, editing these and getting it all put together. So I hope you're enjoying it. And thank you, James. Not seen much of James today, so I don't know whether he's at work today. But wherever you are, James, thumbs up to you. Thank you very much. Talking of thank you very much, Elvis, if you're still out there, hope you're feeling okay, mate. Thank you very much there, James. Hey, James is there. Great stuff. Hope you're enjoying what we've done here. And towards the end of the show, I will try to bring James in and have a quick chat. So that's probably in around about 5 minutes from now.
Calmier in center, call you again, Dave. I'm downwind right-handed. Calmier at the moment. Roger, there are two or three fighters airborne, couple held in front of us.
Also, a good afternoon to Danny. Bell of Aberystwyth. And everybody else that's out there today. So thank you very much. Keep putting the messages into the chat room and we'll certainly give you a mention. So thank you. So this is what Tuesday afternoons were about. I tried to find some old video footage. Especially some classic warbirds as well. But hey, what a bonus you had today. You had Formula One Grand Prix racing as well. And an air show from 1985, believe it or not. Sorry, 1986. From the British Grand Prix at the wonderful Brands Hatch. So that's a bit of variety for you today. Well, I've got to admit, James, I don't like your filming from 92. I love it! Sorry, I'm doing the Muppets again. I've got to stop that. It's terrible! But it's not that bad. Well, I loved it. We all did. But remember, in the background, the bear has been very, very busy doing the video editing. And I tried to let you into a little insight yesterday about doing video editing. But I'm going to revisit that one probably next week. So, James, keep going through those old tapes, okay? Want to feature some more old classic stuff from the early 90s. Especially the Warbirds.
Thank you.
So with a little bit of luck, we will try and see if our very own young Jamesy, James the man, is actually out there. So James, are you out there on this Tuesday afternoon?
I am indeed.
Hey, there he is, as if by magic. Hey, so James, are you enjoying the afternoon show that we're doing today?
Oh, definitely. Yes, very good.
Absolutely. Hey, what did you think to the Humberside? Was that okay?
Yes, very good, thank you.
Absolutely. Brilliant stuff. And you may have seen the fancy menus and all of that. And
yes, yeah. Yep. I did on the Duxford one, but not on the Humberside one.
Ah, you was a little bit late, were you? Put your hands out. James, put your hand out right now. Put your hand out. How dare you? I don't know if Formula One was your sort of thing, but I just thought I would...
Yes, it was good. Yes, I enjoyed it.
Yeah? Did you enjoy the Airshow stuff as well? Gosh.
Oh, yes. Yeah, very good. Yes.
Absolutely. Yep. And it's coming... I mean, I'm viewing this on the... before it actually goes out to you guys. So this old footage, it's coming out okay, is it?
Yeah, let me just turn the sound down. Yes, it is. Yes.
It's coming out very good.
Yep.
Of course,
it's coming out well, yeah.
Fantastic. It's going to be a little bit grainy, guys, but hey, what do you expect? For way back in 1992, but hey, we went back even further to 1985, so...
86.
And 85.
Oh.
You're not keeping up. So, James, you're fit and fine and you're well and you haven't had any snow in your part of the world.
No, we haven't had any snow at all.
Fantastic.
No, my mum's very disappointed.
I'm not. I hate the stuff.
Yep. Some good filming by Jimbo.
Not bad at all. I've told you earlier. I told you it's not good. It's fantastic.
Yes. Yeah.
So thank you very much.
Considering it's 1992, I'm quite impressed.
Well, it's a long time ago, wasn't it, hey?
So
well done there, James. Okay, listen, I'm going to let the folks enjoy the sound of this aircraft without us talking over the top, but I just wanted to quickly pull you in so you could say hi to everybody. So, James, say
hi,
bye.
Cheers, bye.
So, James, say bye, James.
Bye.
No, you're supposed to say bye. James. Thank you. Take care, James. Catch you later. Bye.
Yep, bye, James.
So thank you very much there, James. Okay, I'm going to go really quiet and let you enjoy the last few bits of this particular show.
Thank you.
Danny, thank you very much for joining us this afternoon, and it's an absolute pleasure. Don't forget, subscribe to Airshow World, hit the bell icon, and of course, you'll know when we're live. There, Bell, much appreciated. Thanks for the kind words. Encourages to keep on going. It certainly does. Elvis, thank you for being in the chat room today. It's much appreciated. You always put a smile on my face. Ever since the very, very start of these live streams, so it's great to see you. Hope you're feeling better, okay? Take care, mate. Don't forget, always come up and see us and make us smile. There we go. Who sung that? I'll give you the clue. What's not Elvis? Just got a few minutes left of the show. Just before we actually do leave you, we had a word with Maurice. And of course, we had a word with James. So just before we do actually leave you today, we'll just quickly pull Julie in to say hello. And then we'll be leaving you. But you never know. The bear could be back later this afternoon. Who knows? That's why it's important. Okay, there's nothing scheduled, but if we get the urge, the need, if we get the need for speed, we may just hit the button and go live for you one more time later today. Who knows? That's why it's important. Make sure you subscribe to Airshow World. Make sure you're logged into these Google accounts and all of the rest of it so you get those notifications, so you know when the bear is live. With a little bit of luck, we are going to see if we can see if Julie, you know Julie, she's got the spanner. She's got the spanner in the chat room. So we will just see before we wrap up today's show, because we've just got a couple of minutes left, and we'll just see if Julie is actually out there today. So we'll say her name, knock three times. Julie, are you with us today? Are you there?
Hello, Stu. Hello, everyone.
Hey, Julie. Great to hear you. I am live on the air today. So, you having a good day up there in your part of the world?
Liverpool, you always remember, but never remember where I am. I'm near Liverpool. Yeah, yes, it's not too bad.
I don't like to give it away, you see. I like your voice to give it away whereabouts you are.
Does it get... I always think I sound really posh, so I probably don't.
No, you don't. You don't sound posh. No, you sound great, honestly. You really do. I love the accent, you know. It's not too broad. It's good. I love all people.
It's just enough for you to understand me, which is good.
We can understand you, yes. So, hey, did you get the snow in your part of the world?
No, just a load of rain, so we've been really lucky. It's absolutely thrown it down, but it's not too bad now. I managed to see the beluga before, because that went over. So that was just below the clouds. Did a circle at Liverpool Airport and went into Harden.
Ah. Well, I'm pleased you got to see that. I thought I was going to have to do a replay of it to show everybody again, you know, the when I filmed it a couple of weeks ago. But as you saw it, that's the important thing.
Well, I saw the F1 footage as well, which was absolutely... I know I've had a sneak preview before, but yep. The F1 footage is just absolutely superb.
I know you like your motor racing, so I thought you'd appreciate that. And looks like a lot of folks certainly enjoyed that in the chat room this afternoon. So thank you very much, everybody, for joining us on that. And the messages said, yeah, like that bit of Formula One. So got loads more, but it's... trying to find them, and we're getting there, you know. Was that the cat? Was it my cat?
Oh, no, that was my one. You're all right, it was one of ours.
Ah, right, mine decided to leave me. Well, guys, that's just about it for today. So thank you very, very much, everybody, that's joined us on this Tuesday afternoon. So from, Morris, thank you for Morris and for his input. James, thank you to you. And Julie, thank you very much indeed for all your help today. So who knows, we may be live again later in the day. I'm not going to say whether we are or whether we aren't. Who knows? That's why, make sure you subscribe to Airshow World. But for the moment, hey, Julie, say bye, Julie.
Bye, Julie.
She got it. Okay, and from myself, the bear in the chair, sat right over here at East Midlands Airport. You take care. Have yourself a great rest of your Tuesday afternoon. And we may see you later. Who knows? Bye for now. Thank you for watching.